Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject steam boilers. And this is lecture number 3 on steam boilers. The topic is boiler mountings and accessories. Boiler mountings are the fittings which are primarily intended for safety of the boiler and complete control of the steam generation process. The boiler, we have different types of mounting in the boiler. According to the Indian boiler regulation, the following mountings are to be installed in the boiler. We require 2 safety valves, 2 water level indicators, a fusible plug, 1 pressure gauge, 1 steam stop valve, 1 feed check valve, 1 blow off cock, and there should be a manhole and mud hole. So these are all the boiler mountings. So safety valve, water level indicator, fusible plug, pressure gauge, steam stop valve, feed check valve, blow off cock, manhole and the mud hole. And here the first 3, safety valve, water level indicator and fusible plug, they are called as safety fittings. So these 3 devices, they are fitted, are installed in the boiler for safety purpose. And the other components, other devices, pressure gauge, steam stop valve, feed check valve, blow off cock and the manhole and the mud hole, they are called as control fittings. So they are required to control the process, steam generation process. So the main purpose of the boiler mounting, safety and control of the steam generation process. So we have different equipments. We will see the construction, working and the function of the various boiler mounting. First, the boiler pressure gauge. So this pressure gauge is very much known to you. So this is Bowden pressure gauge, which you studied in the fluid mechanics and thermodynamics. The pressure gauge is installed to record the steam pressure in the boiler. So it is installed in the at the front side of the boiler drum, which is easily visible to the boiler operator. So boiler operator will record the pressure periodically for effective functioning of the boiler. So if you look at the construction of the boiler pressure gauge, so we have a screw portion. So this portion is attached to the boiler shell, and we have a cock. By opening the cock, we can admit the steam to flow through the tube. And this is called as elliptical cross section Bowden tube. So this is the Bowden tube. So it has got the cross section of ellipse. At the end of the Bowden tube, we have a link and the ratchet. So the hinged point, and we have the sector with the teeth, and this is called as ratchet. And above the ratchet, we have a pinion. And at the center of the pinion, we have a needle or the scale or pointer. And the pointer is moving on the scale. On the body of the pressure gauge, we have the scale where the pressure is calibrated. So pressure is indicated on the scale. So we have the cock, elliptical tube, Bowden elliptical tube, and we have the link, and we have the ratchet and pinion mechanism, and we have a pointer which shows the pressure, and we have a pressure scale. How the pressure gauge is working? So as the steam enters here, it flows through the elliptical tube. So the cross section is ellipse. Because of the pressure, steam pressure, by higher pressure, the steam, the pipe elliptical cross section will try to become circular cross section. So because of the steam pressure is acting on the inner surface of the ellipse, so the circular cross section, it try to become circular cross section, because of it is a metal pipe, copper tube, normally a copper tube, and because of that, this end of the Bowden tube, it is moving, it is deflecting. As it is deflecting, the link is also moving along with the Bowden tube. As the link is moving, so here we have a hinge for the ratchet. So when the link is moving on the top, towards the top, the ratchet will be oscillating, moving in the opposite direction. So as the ratchet is moving in the opposite direction, the pinion will rotate in the clockwise direction, and this pointer will move on the scale to show the pressure. So it is a Bowden pressure gauge, which is very useful and standard and reliable equipment for measuring the pressure. And the pressure will be recorded by the boiler operator. And next mounting is water level indicator. So you look at the diagram. And the water level indicator is installed to ascertain the exact level of water in the boiler. So we should know, we have to maintain a constant level of water in the boiler. So if it is not maintained, there will be overheating of boiler component, which leads to many mechanical problem. So it is mounted at the front side of the boiler and it should be visible, easily visible to the boiler operator. So look at the construction. It is mounted on the boiler drum where we have the water and the steam. And we have horizontal pipe, one pipe on the water side and one pipe on the steam side. And these two pipes are connected by a glass tube. And at the entrance of the pipe, we have the steam cock and the water cock. So by opening the steam cock and the water cock, the steam and the water will be allowed to flow through the water level indicator. So here we have the boil valve. Using the boil valve, so it's actually, suppose if you want to drain the water or the steam, so we can close the cock. So by opening the drain cock, we can drain the water from the gauge, water level indicator. So by opening the water cock and the steam cock, the water level raises in the glass tube and the steam is acting on the at the top of the glass tube. So we can read the water level in the glass tube. And at the top and the bottom, we have a stuffing box. So stuffing box is the, a small box attached to the glass tube. So to connect the two pipes. So this is one pipeline. This is another pipeline. These two pipelines are connected by means of a vertical tube. And here we want leak proof joint. So here the steam should not leak, and here the water should not leak. To prevent the leakage, we have the stuffing box. So stuffing box, inside the stuffing box we have some insulating material, so which will leak proof material, which will prevent the leakage of steam or the water from the joint. And the safety valve, the function of the safety valve is to permit the steam to escape to the atmosphere when the steam pressure exceeds the specified limit. For example, the steam boiler is designed for 10 bar. When the steam pressure inside the boiler is exceeding 10 bar, so we have to allow the steam to leave the boiler so that the pressure will be brought back to the 10 bar. It is very much similar to your whistle in the pressure cooker. So in the pressure cooker, you have a whistle. So what is the function of the whistle? When the steam pressure inside the cooker is higher than the design value, higher than the actual value, then the whistle will lift and the excess steam will be leaving to the atmosphere. Because the steam is leaving through a small opening, so there is a sound. So the whistle sound is created because the steam is escaping through a small opening, small nozzle. Once the steam escapes, so automatically the whistle will go to the original position. So when the force due to the weight and the force due to the steam, when these two are equal, the weight will be in the same position. When the steam force due to the steam is increasing, the weight will be lifted and the steam will be leaving to the atmosphere. And the safety valve is installed in the top of the steam drum. So there are four types of safety valve: deadweight safety valve, lever safety valve, spring loaded safety valve, high steam and low water safety valve. So we will see one by one. So this is the deadweight safety valve. And you look at the construction. So we have a vertical steel pipe. At the top of the vertical steel pipe, we have the valve. So this is the valve arrangement. And we have the weight. 7 is the cover, 6 is the weight. And 9 is the feathers, 3 is the valve, 4 is the valve seat. So this is the valve seat and this is the valve. And 8 is the feather once again, and 2 is the flange. So using the flange, we are attaching the safety valve on the top of the boiler drum. So how this is working? So when the steam, so from here the steam is acting, steam is entering here, and the steam is occupying the space. And the there are two forces in the safety valve. One is the upward force due to the steam pressure, and the downward force due to the weight. So when the downward force is more than the upward force, the valve will be in the seat. The valve will be completely in the seat. When the steam pressure increases, the downward force is less than the upward force. So the entire weight will be lifted, and the valve will be moving in the upward direction, and the weight will be lifted, and through the small opening, so the steam will be escaping, and it is going to the atmosphere. So when the valve is lifted, the steam from the surrounding, so in the gap, there will be gap created between the valve seat and the valve, and the steam will be escaping and leaving to the atmosphere. That is what the dead weight safety valve. And this is lever safety valve. So the working principle is the same. We have an external weight. The external weight, depending on the position of the external weight, there will be force acting on the valve. So this is the here we have Y type of valve, and we have the guide, and we have a fulcrum here, and this is the hinged strut, and this is the valve body. The valve body is attached to the boiler drum. The steam pressure is acting here at the bottom. The force is acting on the bottom of the valve, and the valve will be retained in the seat by adjusting the external weight. So by the lever mechanism, we are retaining the valve in the valve seat. And again, by positioning the weight, we can adjust the steam pressure. So when the steam pressure exceeds the upward downward force, the valve will be lifted, and the steam will be escaping through the small opening created between the valve guide and the valve. So this is called as lever safety valve. And these two valves are very old in design. So nowadays they are not used. And this is very popular. Spring loaded safety valve is very popular, and it is used. So look at the construction. So we have the flange once again. The flange is attached to the boiler drum. The steam is entering here, and you have Y type of arrangement. So the valve body, we have two opening, and the two opening, we have the two valves resting on the valve seat, and here we have a lever, and at the lever is pushing the valve to retain in the valve seat, and the lever is retained in the position by means of the spring force. The spring is tightly fitted with the shackle and the pivot. So there are two forces once again: downward force because of the spring force, and the upward force due to the steam force. When the steam force is less than the downward force due to the spring, the valve will be in the original position. When the steam pressure exceeds the spring pressure, the valves will be lifted from the valve seat, and through the small opening created, the steam will be escaping to the atmosphere. So this is called as a spring loaded safety valve. And this is high steam and low water safety valve. So this you would have studied in the locomotive boiler. We have high steam, low water safety valve. So this safety valve will allow the steam to escape under two conditions. One is high steam quantity or high steam pressure and low water level. And look at the construction here. So here we have a lever A and the weight, balancing weight here. And this is the balance weight, and it is a float. And the valve V2 is here, and this is the valve rod. So this is valve V2, and we have the weight which is giving the downward force, and we have the steam, the passage for steam to escape. So when the boiler is operating under normal condition, the valve will be retained in the valve seat. When the steam pressure exceeds, so the balance weight, so the weight will be lifted. When the weight is lifted, and the valve V2 will be lifted. So when the valve V2 is lifted, so the steam will be escaping through the opening, and it will go to the atmosphere. It will give the warning to the boiler operator. This is the high steam condition. Then low water condition, when the water level is decreasing below the float. So now what will happen? Once again, the weight will go down. And again, it is lifting the valve to open, and the steam will be escaping. So this safety valve is operating, is allowing the steam to escape under high steam pressure and low water level conditions. And fusible plug. So function of the fusible plug is to extinguish the fire in the combustion chamber when the water level goes below the prescribed level. The fusible plug is mounted on the top of the combustion chamber. So you look at the fusible plug. We have the crown plate of the boiler. So this is the gunmetal body. So hexagonal flange and gunmetal body. The hexagonal flange has got the screw. Using the screw, we are attaching the fusible plug on the top of the combustion chamber. And here in the gunmetal body, and the top of the gunmetal body, we have another gunmetal plug. So this is attached by means of a screw. And in the gunmetal plug, we have the copper, solid copper plug. So solid copper plug. In between the solid copper plug and the gunmetal plug, we have some material called fusible metal. So fusible metal will melt due to higher temperature. So when the boiler combustion is taking place, so around the fusible plug, it is at the top of the combustion chamber, it is completely covered with the water. When the water level goes below the predetermined value, so the automatically we have the water level indicator and we have the feed pump. When the water level indicator gives a warning to the boiler operator, the boiler operator fill the water under certain working worst working conditions. Sometimes when the feed pump or the water level indicator is not working, so there will be complete continuous evaporation without adding the water. So in that situation, the water level will go below the determined level. So there will be excess heat. There will be excess heat, but the amount of water available will be low. So due to the excess heat, the fusible metal will melt and the copper plug will fall down and it will be retained in the ribs. When the copper plug is falling down, so there will be opening created in the gunmetal plug. So through the opening, the boiler water will enter into the combustion chamber, which will put off the fire, so which will extinguish the fire. So the purpose of the fusible plug to extinguish the fire when the water level goes below the prescribed level. And the steam stop valve, it is very much similar to your ordinary tap what we are using at our home. To regulate the steam stop valve is used to regulate the flow of the steam from the boiler to the turbine. So the function of the steam stop valve is to regulate the flow of steam from the boiler to the steam engine or the turbine. It is mounted on the highest part of the steam drum and is connected to the steam pipe. And what is the construction? So look at here, we have the body of the steam stop valve, and we have the valve disc and valve seat, and we have a hand wheel with a spindle and a gland here. So everything is tightly fitted. When you rotate the hand wheel, so the valve will be lifted from the valve disc will be lifted from the valve seat, and there will be gap created. So through the gap, the steam from the boiler will go to the turbine. So this is the steam stop valve, and this is the blow off cock. So the blow off cock, the function of the blow off cock is to empty the boiler for inspection and cleaning, and it is fitted at the lowest part of the boiler drum. So it is something like a drain cock. Normally in the water tank at our home, so we have a pipeline at the bottom of the water tank. So the pipeline is used for draining the water tank during the cleaning purpose. So when you clean the water tank, so we have to drain all the water. So like that, when you want to inspect and clean the boiler, we have to drain all the water from the boiler drum. So using the blow off cock, we drain all the water. So here you look at here, this is the pipeline, so through which the water will be from the boiler will be escaping to the atmosphere, and here we have the valve. So this plug is there. So by rotating the plug, so the water will be moving, water will be completely drained from the boiler. And the feed check valve. So feed check valve is used to allow the feed water to flow into the boiler and to prevent the backflow of water. So feed check valve is allowing the water to flow through the feed pump. So feed check valve is installed between feed pump and the water space in the boiler shell. So it is between the feed pump and the boiler shell. So here it is again a valve. So the water from the feed pump is coming here. It is lifted by the valve, and the valve, by rotating the hand wheel, we can lift the valve, the water will go to the boiler, and the valve V2 will be closed. So when there is backflow of the water, and this valve will close the water, So we have V2 valves, V1 and V2. So by adjusting the hand wheel, we can lift the V1 to admit the flow of water to the boiler. When you close the hand wheel, V1 will close, and the V2 is also preventing the backflow of water from the boiler to the feed pump. And next one is boiler accessories. So the boiler mountings and the boiler accessories, they are boiler accessories are installed to increase the efficiency of the boiler by utilizing the flue gases. We are increasing the efficiency. The various boiler accessories are air preheater, economizer, superheater, feed pump, and the steam injector. And the air preheater. So air preheater is a waste heat recovery equipment. So it is recovering the waste heat of the flue gases. It is used to heat the air before supplied to the furnace by using the heat of the flue gases. So the air preheater, economizer, and superheater, they are installed to increase the efficiency. So the advantage of air preheater, the air preheater increases the efficiency of the boiler by 2% for each 30 to 40 degree rise in the temperature of the air. The increase of the evaporation increases the evaporation rate, that is amount of steam produced per kg of coal. It increases the combustion efficiency and reduces the soot, smoke and the ash formation. So the soot formation, the flue gases, and the smoke formation and the ash formation, they are reduced. So using the air preheated air, high temperature air, we can use the low grade coal in the boiler. So that is another advantage. Low grade coal means it may contain more ash, or it may contain the wet condition. It may, moisture content will be very high. So we can use low grade coal. It increases the combustion efficiency, it increases the evaporation rate, and it also increases the boiler overall efficiency by 2%. And this is the two types of air preheater what is used in the boiler plant. One is tubular air preheater, another one is plate type of air preheater. So look at the construction. We have number of vertical tubes, and around the tube the air is flowing, and inside the tube the flue gases are flowing. So the flue gases from the boiler, it is entering here. So the flue gases are flowing through the pipeline. So the hot flue gases are flowing inside the pipeline, and they are collected, and the soot and the fly ashes are collected at the bottom, and the flue gases, they are leaving to the chimney. And around the tube we are circulating the cold air. Cold air from the atmosphere is drawn inside, and it is flowing across the tubes. So it absorbs the heat energy from the surface of the tubular air preheater, and the hot air is supplied to the furnace. This is tubular air preheater. And this plate type of air preheater, so we have vertical plates, and in between the vertical plates we have the space. So alternatively, in the space we are circulating hot gases and the cold air. So look at here. So we have the vertically upward direction. At the bottom the cold air is entering, and it is moving in the space between the plates, and it is leaving, hot air is leaving on the other side. And from the back side the flue gases are entering, and the gases are flowing in the horizontal direction from the back side to the front side, and they are leaving to the atmosphere. So this is called as plate type of air preheater. And we discussed the air preheater in detail in the fifth unit, where we have a topic called waste heat recovery equipment. The next accessory is economizer. Economizer is also a waste heat recovery equipment, which increases the temperature of the feed water using the heat of the flue gases. The advantages of the economizer: it increases the boiler efficiency, reduction in the loss of heat in the flue gases, increases the steam generation rate of the boiler, that is evaporation rate, and less thermal stresses to the boiler component leads to long life of the boiler. So economizer, it increases the temperature of the feed water, temperature of the water into the supply to the boiler. And this is the economizer. So we have horizontal tube, tubular structure. So through which, through the tube, inside the tube the water is circulated, and outside the tube the hot flue gases are flowing. So the hot flue gases, they are entering at the bottom of the economizer. It is moving vertically in the upward direction. Here we have number of horizontal tubes, tube bundle. This is called as tube bundle, and inside the tube we are circulating water. So the water is at lower temperature, the gases are at a higher temperature. The water absorbs the heat energy from the flue gases, and the hot water will be supplied to the boiler. And here on the surface, outer surface of the tubes, we have the gills or the fins. So these are used for increasing the heat recovery rate. Amount of heat absorbed by the water will be increased by means of the fins. So this is economizer used to increase the temperature of the feed water. And superheater. So superheater, so we studied about the steam. We have one quality, one steam is called superheated steam, which have higher enthalpy. The superheated steam will have a higher enthalpy. So superheater is a heat exchanger which increases the temperature of the steam above the saturation temperature by using the heat from the flue gases. There are two types of superheater. One is radiant superheater, another one is convective superheater. By using the superheater, the advantages of the superheater increases the work output of the turbine and the boiler efficiency. There is no condensation of steam in the pipeline connecting the boiler and the turbine. Absence of moisture in the steam reduces the friction and erosion in the steam turbine blade. And this is the two types of superheater. One is the radiant superheater, another one is convective superheater. So radiant superheater, it is installed near the combustion chamber, near the furnace. The amount of heat absorbed by the radiant superheater is by the radiation mode of heat transfer. So there are three modes of heat transfer: radiation, convection and conduction. So the radiant superheater, it absorbs maximum amount of heat energy by radiation, and the convection superheater, it is in the convection zone. It is away from the boiler combustion chamber, boiler the furnace. It absorbs the heat energy by means of convection mode of heat transfer. So that is why it is called as convective heat superheater, and this is called as radiant superheater. So the superheater installed in the radiation zone, it is called as radiant superheater. The superheater installed in the convection zone is called as convective superheater. And we stop here. So these are all the books I published earlier: Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Fluid Machinery. And also I have a YouTube where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects. Also I upload the solution for the GATE question paper, which will be useful for your better learning and pass in the GATE examination. So subscribe the channel, use the YouTube videos for your better learning and pass in the subject. Thank you for watching. So you please post your comments on the comments box in the video, and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. I will sincerely answer to your queries. So thank you for watching. We'll meet again with another topic in the steam boiler.